بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إحرام actually it's a status that you enter in. Okay. The word إحرام it is a status that you are entering into. It means it comes from the word حرام. You know what حرام means? It means forbidden. Okay. So إحرام I'm entering into a status where are some action are forbidden for me or for me to do. For example, when we go to pray, you have what you call takbiratul ihram, to say Allahu Akbar. That is called takbiratul ihram. It means I'm going to go into an ihram status in the salah, and it is haram for me while I'm praying to eat, for example, or talk, or walk around, you know, or clip my nails, etc., etc. Okay. So that's why it's called takbirat al-ihram. Now, when we go in Hajj, we also go into an ihram status. But for that, we don't say Allahu Akbar. We say something else, and we do something else. Now, while we are in the ihram status on Hajj or Umrah, one of the things we can't do is we cannot wear our usual garment. So that have to be taken off, okay? That have to be removed, not in front of people, of course. This have to be removed, everything have to be removed, okay? Now, the sunnah is to have a complete ghusl or a shower. And your intention, you are doing ghusl al-ihram. That's your intention, the way to ghusl al-ihram. And you don't have to say it, because your action is your intention. Like, what are you going to shower for? Could you going to have a shower so you could go into ihram status? But up until now, you do not say the intention of ihram. You are not in ihram status. You merely having a ghusl so that you go into the ihram. Okay? Like, for example, if somebody do a ghusl to go to Jum'ah prayer, it doesn't mean he's in Jum'ah prayer, does it? In the Friday prayer. He may do his ghusl for Jum'ah prayer, for Friday prayer at 9 o'clock in the morning. So anyway, so that if you do ghusl for ihram. After doing the ghusl, that is a sunnah, no, you don't have to. You take the atar. Anybody's got atar? Atar is just...
Oh,
okay. No?
Oh, yeah, I have, sorry, yeah.
Yeah,
it's the one here.
There you go. Okay, I got two. Now, atar, it's the oil, actually. The oil that is perfume. Okay, the Arab perfume. And the sunnah is to use oud. It's called oud. Okay, that's the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam favor when he do the ghusl for Umrah. Or, if you can't find oud, then misk or musk. If you can't find, then but something that actually that is nice. You know, you don't get something that is people dislike. Mm-hmm. And sometimes what you could do actually ask me if something that you feel. Ask me what do you think that's nice? Do you think that's nice if you're not sure about it? Okay. But oud, that is definitely. And oud is made of oil, okay, or some sort of ointment. Okay, they used to rub it on your skin. Okay, so you get that. Okay, that is not oud, by the way. It has something else. And you smear it all over you, as much as you want. Don't worry. That's after you had your shower. And that, obviously, that smell will remain on. You know, during your tawaf, etc. That is no problem. There's no harm in that. Don't worry about it. Okay? But once you go into the status of ihram, then you don't touch it anymore until you come out of it. Another thing you can't do with this, you cannot get your ihram clothes and say, I'm going to rub, you know, with outer. No, you don't do that. You do it on your body. Okay? Now, after that, if it goes from that into that, that is not your problem. Okay? So that is a sunnah, not a fard. Now, the things that you are not allowed to wear is anything that is made in the shape of your body, like a sewn material. Can you use the other door? Yeah. Right. So you got two garments that you wear. Okay. You cannot wear this because it is sewn to the shape of my arm and my body. I cannot wear that because it's shown to the shape of my legs, etc. You cannot wear an underpants because they are shaped and sewn to the shape of your body. So it says you can wear two garments. One is izar that goes around, yeah, and one is rida, it's called. How do we wear them? You cannot wear ordinary shoes. It is better to wear sandals, it's called na'al, or you are allowed to wear a khuf or a shoe that is cut to below the ankle. Yeah, below the ankle in here. So if you have a look. Yeah, that's okay. Can I have so these, for example, they are okay because they are cut below the ankle. If there are half boots, for example, or boots, that is not allowed. Yeah. So if you can't buy a solid sand, etc., like you get issues, if they're too high, just cut them with the scissors, then you're all right.
But these are stitched, so...
It doesn't matter. That doesn't matter, okay?
So the front of the bone doesn't have to be bare?
No. It doesn't have to be bare. This is allowed. But it is better to wear the sandal if you can. It's not the stitching, actually. It's the sewing. Because this causes a bit of stitches anyway. Okay? Right, so... Then many people, they make big mistake with this. They go like that. They go like that. They go, ihram. They covered. That is actually very dangerous. Because, you're going all over the place, you're going down the stairs, etc. So it's too tight. You cannot get on the bus with this. You have to hop. Like a sack potato in it. Potato sack race. Right. So how we get around this problem? Very easy. So, but watch carefully. Okay? Right. So I've got this now. Like that. Equal length. Turn it around. So it's on the side. Okay? So get it as high as you can. So that the bottom of it